Hey, what's up guys, and welcome to the final video of DoomCraft. Yes, it's not the very final video, there will be more videos of course, but this is the end of the map. I don't know when I'll upload this, probably like a few days before I start the next map, but not anytime soon. However, I'm going to do a world tour right now. I hope I'm recording. Oh, what? Okay, that was weird. So I'm just going to do a world tour. The last world tour was an episode 1, but a lot of things have changed. I don't even know what episode this is. Episode 8, something like that. Episode 9, probably. I don't know. So we're going to start by looking at my stuff. And then I'll go let you see what everyone else has built. So I'm on 9 deaths, yeah. Not the smallest amount of deaths. I think I'm second smallest. Going to look at the achievements. Done quite a bit actually. Look at that. That's loads. Statistics. Played for quite some time here. Really? Only 27 seconds. That's interesting. Jumps, quite a bit. Damage dealt, oh yeah. I'll tell you why in a minute. Number of deaths, 10. Oh yeah, because the first time I died before I started the system, I was just experimenting with something and didn't count really. So, let's carry on. Someone's on Skype, okay. Items dropped. What time is it? It's quarter to 11. So you'll be featured in the video, of course, whoever it is on Skype. Here are my items. You can just pause the video if you want to have a better look at it. Well, this is blocks. This is items. Diamonds. Nothing too interesting here. Mobs is more interesting, however. Creepers. Apparently, I don't get killed by. Oh, great. Just be back in a minute. Alright, I'm back. Let's carry on with the tour. Sorry, I had to go there. So let's look in all my chests. This is the mob loot chest. I have one with a skull in there. Got some bows. Not really supposed to be in there, but lots of blaze rods. This might be quite a long episode, actually, now that I think of it. My stone chest, although lately I've been messing around. Dirt chest, and gravel, sand, whatever. Plant chest. Goodies chest, lots of diamonds, oh yeah. Quite a bit of redstone. Glass chest. My ender chest. The awesome sword of destruction. I have another one here. What does it say? King Arthur's legendary swords brother. Alright. One of my friends did that. And one of my friends also did a prank. Someone pranked someone else, yeah, and I let them use command blocks, and I'm never going to let anyone cheat again apart from myself. And they used command blocks to spawn in Herobrine, and things that didn't even use their own commands, because they're stupid. And Herobrine had this baby, and he pretty much ripped us apart. Does this have infinity? Yeah. Okay, let's carry on. Here's my randoms chest. Dagger's helmet. I don't need anything apart from my boots. And I have lots and lots of records here. Let's put on something good. What shall I put on? Well, ward is good, but yeah, why not? Well, that's a bit loud. hit 10%. Wood might not sound that great, but you really need to carry on listening it, and it sounds amazing. I'm pretty envious for Daniel Rosenfield for creating that. It's really good. Well done, man. Here I've got my chest full of random crap. Who's there? Oh, they're different books, okay. They have different content. There's my chest of random stuff again. Another boat there. Got a chest full of cobblestone and stuff like that. This chest is kind of like not even supposed to be here, but I just have it there. This chest, I use this little area for putting down chests with building materials for things I was going to go and build. Let's go down here to my basement. Let's hope no one messed it up. Okay, that's already messed up. I remember now. So, I had a creeper blow up somewhere here. No. Okay, that's down there is my strip mine, my own personal one. Oof. Here is my furnace room. Yeah, I love this furnace room. It's so cool. Do I have anything in there? I've got coal here, so one of these does a stack. One slot, it does a whole stack of items. Got smelted stuff there. Looking at all the inventory slots gives you a seizure. Or can give you a seizure. Okay, apparently I've got nothing in them. Here I have Snowman, but someone killed him. Because everyone's a jerk on this server. Okay. Oh, I've got lots of stuff here from digging this out. It was actually kind of fun digging this out. Got lots more stuff and a reed and a bunch of reeds. Cause I have a huge reed farm here. And of course someone had to break it. And of course I never used these pistons, so I just made a crap ton of pistons for no reason. I actually used this room, including that, what's back here, for a PvP battle with Treebeard, and that's why I put more deaths. And you can shoot out of the eyes here, like shoot your bow. It was fun. Quite a bit of fun, actually. So I just made a bunch of rooms here that you can go and fight in. Carrying on, just past this reed farm. Sugarcane, sorry. I always get mad whenever someone calls them reeds, and I just did that. Me and Parsnip King, or Jim Bob as his YouTube name is, Jim Bob Handyman, we're building a little kind of fort thing, a little private thing here. I saw something somewhere. Just over that, I think. Is it? Yeah. That's a little tunnel thing he did. So let's get out of here and let me show you some other stuff. What do I have in here? Nothing. That stayed there forever, did nothing with it. Over here, this is where I get like my stone from, like to polish things up, because just why not? Oh no, that's where I got my cobblestone from, because I need cobblestone. You see, I was expecting to run over here, yeah? No, I had to run here. Up the stairs here is the top part of my house, and you can see everything pretty clearly. Just over there. Oh no, that's not the potion lab. Anyway, nothing ever went up here, and I don't like this wall here. I think it's kind of in the way. Obstructs everything. If I was to do something like this, I'd just have fences again. Fences like here. Because that's really annoying. Over there, I was... In the last few days, I was trying to build, like, down hole, yeah? The squiggly means that it has been sidebaying me. So, it's official. Although, someone can just break the sign and sign it as themselves or some... or whatever. Here are the beacons, the coloured beacons. No longer named, but they are all full beacons. The tower is full, you can see all of the strength, speed, everything that you can get. Jump boost is only one, because I wanted to regen and I couldn't bother to have sixth. Wow, I'm dumb at math. Sorry, I just woke up. Over here, you may remember there was like a ton of a room with a ton of mobs there. I've got rid of that because people were going there and blowing up redstone from the community hub. So here are the rules of the server. If you are new to this world, no stealing, pranks do not involve anything to do with fire, destruction, anything that can basically break blocks. If you break anything, put it back to how it was, DoomSkull. Here I've got a little tunnel going to lead him to community hub. And I have it say, welcome to community hub. Did I not fill it in properly? Oh, how did you get in here? Weird. Here's like an enchanting room. Over here was supposed to be a map of the world, but someone... And I actually had it done, but someone broke it. And yeah. Here is like a... like an everything kind of thing. Brewing stands, storage, water. Anvil and the chest. Everything that you need to know. Over here is a teleportation room, which teleports you to different parts of the world. So let's go to Doom's fishing first, why not? So this is like a fishing area. This is the fresh crate, so to go back to community hub. So this is fish, this is cooked fish, this is like rods. This is miscellaneous, random junk in there though. Miscellaneous is supposed to be for fish that you like can't eat, or tags or something. And of course, some stupid person had to have broken the things, the rules of it. Okay, let's go back. We've got Mines of Moria, which is the second thing we built, I think. I don't know. There's the mine, and stone loading in. Okay. It's a strip mine, whatever you want to call it. Branch mine is what I prefer calling it, branch mine, because you branch off to places. These are supposed to be like stone and stuff. But I used to put my goodies in here and my stone in there. This is a manual way up from Mines of Moria, which I am not going to take. I'm just going to show you later on what it looks like, because I don't want to keep this episode too long. Load in. Thank you. Oh. Okay. Thank you. That's it for Community Hub. I'll show you them later on. Okay. This chest was just kind of random. I killed someone here and the spawn point was ages away from here. So I put all this stuff in the chest. I think it was Parsnip King I killed. This is Parsnip King's first house. The little enchanting area. Random junk. More junk. not that bad. I'm not even going to go down there because I get lost every time I go there. So I'm just going to show you that later on in spectator mode, because I can. This is where people stored their horses. This is my favourite project ever, because I did it, and it's actually useful, and it's actually complete, well, more or less. This is a mob farm. Etho's design, sorry Etho, I had to copy you, but it's really efficient and I do like it. So let's go down there and see. Well, okay. Let's see how efficient it is. I was not able to make the item sorters because I wasn't back then. I do know how to do it now though. So got lots and lots of gunpowder, lots of bones, lots of other stuff. Had some witches here, so get glowstone, sugar, redstone, best thing of all. Well, maybe gunpowder is because I like TNT. Here's some stuff. Did I actually hook that up to a one hit kill though? I think I did. So that the lights are off and they stop spawning. So we might have a few more come down, but they should have stopped spawning now. If you see any particles, that's because there's something underneath this. And I'm going to turn it back on because I like stuff spawning. Here's a one-hit kill thing, or if light is off, it's an instant kill. If it's on and it's a one-hit kill. Let's see how that works. Creepers apparently are not affected by these. They need to have damage potions, which is pretty annoying. But everything else gets killed by these. Got any chests there because they need it for the item sorter. Come on, man. What's taking so long? Anyway, TP Dooms. Okay, I remember now. I need to turn this on. Because that's what I would have had in on this thing. So as you can see, the zombie didn't die, and none of them will die unless they have armor. Then they'll definitely not die, and I'll have to kill them somehow else. But the point is that you just approach them at the corner, they die, give you XP. However, it doesn't work. The health potions don't work on creepers, and that's really annoying. TP DoomSkull to whatever this is. 30. Yep. Wait, that did not work. Apparently, this is further than 30 blocks down. 50. Okay, that worked. Teleport me to right about there. I got this out of snow because it's easy to get and also need some colour contrast in this world. Over here, I've got a charged creeper encased in a cage. Don't ask why, I just wanted to have one and he's over a lava pit. I've got it encased in barrier blocks because people are stupid and kept killing him. And I had to get more creepers, and I named him Electro, because why not? How old is this chest here? Probably been there ever since I started the world. Karen with the tour. This is Treebeard's old house, but it no longer is. I don't remember whose it is now, but it's obviously... Okay. They're obviously stupid because, well, Treebeard is pretty stupid because he didn't take any of his stuff, A. B, he left my present behind. I'm so sad now. Still got potions here. Come on, like, wow, man, wow. I'm not even going to go in there because someone pranked him. Die, bat. Oh, I love that sound. Up here, welcome to the Dungeon Master Office / Forge. Grand opening sale. Okay, whatever. Whatever, boss. This is Treebeard's kind of like shop kind of thing, except I do not approve of it. Because A, he's too close to spawn. B, I just don't approve of it because he killed me once and I lost all my stuff there because he did not think about that properly. But, rules, no breaking blocks, no cheating, survive and have fun. Hard dungeon rewards 4 diamonds, epic dungeon rewards 5 diamonds, and this key, what he did is have like dungeons, and thing, this another really stupid thing is that he would go into creative mode and spawn in stuff to kill us. That's really annoying because A, he's not allowed to do that, especially for killing. And the dungeons are pretty stupid as well. They don't look anywhere near as good as they should. And also, it's all messy. I'm just going to go into spectator mode because it's going to be easier to go around. This is Parsnip King's second house. Got his stuff in there. I actually prefer this one to his old one. Although it's too close to my house and I don't really like that. Oh, I didn't go to Doom Streets yet. Let's do that. Oh no. Crap. Oh crap. Great. Let's fix this real quick. This is rule number what, 4? Break whatever you break? No, fix whatever you break. I like that rule. Okay. Dream Street. So it's a tree farm. People of course are stupid and don't replant. Put tools in there, got other stuff in there. What was I going to say? Yeah, let's go check out Treebeard's now house. If I can survive the night. Oh, great. That's a great start, isn't it? I can one hit kill spiders and I like that a lot. Maybe I should have first gone to my potion lab because I don't have any effects here. This is a fort, whatever. Owly was here. Wow. Another stupid thing. Like, come on, just have it automatic. Come on. That doesn't even work. Oh, I think it doesn't work because in 1.9 there was an update or something. No, it just doesn't work. Full stop. Castle, Camelot Castle. Oh, he's got a few diamonds in there. And the dragon egg, which isn't supposed to be there. Empty bottles go here. Basically what he has here is beer. And there's no way I'm drinking this, because it's just... meh. No. You've got heads in here. Again, he used command blocks, which I really don't approve of. And that gives you beer, this command block, which is broken. So let's get out of here because I don't like this area. It's boring, doesn't look good. Sorry, Treebeard, but it just doesn't look good. How did he see me all the way from there? Oh, that spider must be blind. Okay. I've gotten pretty good at fighting in the 1.9 update. Let's go to my potion lab next, because it's way better there. Oh wait, it's not, because someone blew it all up. Of course. So I've got the. I didn't change any of the prices, I don't think. Maybe I should have changed them to a bit lower. I had a ton of villagers here and someone killed them all. But, and someone took a stack of my emeralds. Wow. I had a ton of emeralds here. So I've got potions. Up here was supposed to be a manual brewing thing, but everyone just took brewing stands with them. Down here is the actual lab, which is the which was the best part. Wow. It's the books are everywhere. Got my swiftness potions here. Which are like most poison, regen and strength. More swiftness, yeah. And this is what I'm most proud of. Look how many gas tiers I've got. That is so amazing. Never have I thought I'd hold a stack of gas tiers in Minecraft. Yet I am doing that now. And someone had to blow this up. Does this still have anything in it? Weakness, okay. Then that works still. Ran out of bottles, apparently. Oh, I still got quite a few things on here. Anyway, let's go. I always do that. That still works. Over here is a mushroom farm, or it was. And I've got light level just right so mobs don't spawn in there and mushrooms can still grow. It's so that I can make fermented spider eyes, although on next season I'll probably have it all in my potion lab. Where am I going? There's nothing there. Got a little reed farm here, but it's completely useless, that's why I built the other one. Over here is something I also did by the end of the server. I was trying to have a villager kind of area where I could trade with them, and I had it all working, but what I didn't count on is that in the new updates, zombies see absolutely miles, and I'm not even kidding, if you light up 100 meter circle around this, yeah, they will still find their way through, and because these are glass panes, they can attack through them. And also someone must have killed them too. But I've made a pretty cool thing here. I would have the villagers in there, I'd flick a lever, I could trade with them, look it back, they're safe. And I was going to have more spots there, but they all kept dying. And I really like how, I had a whisper there, I really like how the quartz and the cyan looks like. I think it's my favorite thing ever now. It's just so good. As you can see, I also did that there. In the next season, I'll probably mainly build like that, or all of my shops will be built like that. What do we have left? I think I'm going to start losing my wits in a minute. Here I have got the watchtower from episode whatever it was. And it's basically a tower where someone can look out for opponents, except everyone's friends on the server, and they Again, they can basically shoot from here. I was actually going to have another sniper tower, but didn't have time for it. I had a clock there. Oh, you know what? Maybe it was a glitch. It must have been a glitch then, because I heard from other YouTubers that all the item frames broke. So it must be a glitch that all the item frames broke. Just there from the building materials. This is Owly's house. And someone else's, I don't remember whose. I know who it is in person, but I forgot the name. They've also got to read from here. Okay, not bad. I actually pranked these guys by putting Obby everywhere, and I think that's what they used to prank Treebeard's house. Dudes, come on, you don't need glass. The lava's far enough not to catch this on fire. Come on, dudes. But yeah, this house isn't that bad. Okay, I know why there's so much stuff in here. Owly was the farmer on the server. And I'll show you the farms in just a second. I still haven't hooked up the command blocks to it, I don't think. Is a manual labor thing. I would not trust them with anything, to be honest. But they like what this shop does is they get paid to do stuff that other people might not want to do, which is pretty clever. So the farms have turned wild. There's a lot of cows here. Over here. Ooh, this can be harvested. Let's eat in action. Okay, I had a crash there, sorry. Apparently pistons are very glitchy. But what happens when I press the button? I should probably have a pressure plate or something. Actually, no, that's what I used to have. I don't know, I should have put like a... I should have lengthened the signal somehow, because it took me 4 tries to get all the wheat from the far sides over to here, to the middle. But yeah, I had a crash there. I think that's why I stopped recording on the server. I kept having crashes whenever I tried recording. And what was supposed to happen here? I don't know. So how that works is I press the button, pistons retract, so they're inverted. Pistons retract, let the water out. Simple. Anything else to show? I remember that. I tried to kill someone with an animal and I succeeded. Lol. Oh my god. That was funny. They're like, what? Over here was supposed to be a horse stable. And originally it had sheep in it. And then they died. Funny thing. They all died from lightning. That was like the funniest thing ever. Let's go in the nether now. We just had another episode, in our LP series, and I'm sick and tired of the nether, but this nether is more finalized. It actually has buffs in it. Maybe not. Maybe it's still just useless. Oh my god. Stop the lag. Oh yeah, forgot. Someone made a long, long track across the whole nether and I have no idea what it's for. Just goes to nowhere, goes into a wall, literally. Okay, I better not get lost in this nether because I haven't been on this world since, what, February, so about 3 months, and I have no idea where I'm going right now. All I know is that I'm looking for another fortress, which is somewhere that way, I'm pretty sure. Oh yeah, episode whatever it was, we also got lost in this nether, so good to see it again, isn't it? Yeah, I think it's in this direction. Well, I could have just gone from there, couldn't you mind? Okay. Yeah, that's the fortress. Here, I have a blaze farm. Unfortunately, it is not the way I wished to have it, but I didn't have much time and I was pretty sick of the nether by the point I finished it. Because I spent way too long in here. I always spend too long in the nethers for some reason. It's not that I like it, it's just that I always go there. Okay. Okay, good. Oh yeah, I remember I had barrier blocks here. Which is more helpful actually. And apparently I didn't calculate this right. So I'll have to move the bench a lot further back. Here I've got building materials, blaze rods themselves, stuff there. This was used. I don't remember how many times I need to hurt them though. But I've got a blaze spawner there, and I have it so they all go. I have it so if they land on a pressure plate, they'll be pushed, and one of them is suffocating right now because that's a glitch. Oh, it doesn't matter that really. And they get pushed further down, and they land on another set of pressure plates. Sometimes they land on the edge, like that one over there, and they just get stuck there. But eventually, they'll get bumped by another blaze, and it will all be fine. On the corners, I have it push them to the right and onto that pressure plate. So if you landed on that pressure plate, you'll be pushed onto that pressure plate, pushing you forwards. Come on, blazers. Jungles all day long. Anyway. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, I think that's how many times I need to hurt them. Apparently not. Okay, apparently not. Probably like 16. And I can manually hit them as well, but they fly up. They tend to fly up and shoot fireballs. So as you can see from that little small batch, I just got 41 blaze rods, which is really helpful because they're used in furnaces. And I would rather use them in furnaces than coal. And that guy is tracking me currently. So let's get the hell out of here. Get what I did there. we're in hell. Oh, that's funny. Let's go out. I'm going to show the end because there's nothing there. However, we did kill the Ender Dragon. Well, technically I did. Because everyone else died. And I did not kill them, okay? They're just noobs. You can respawn the Ender Dragon, so someone was really sad that they didn't go with us, and I just told them that they can respawn the Ender Dragon in 1.9, so they should just do that. I just realized I haven't played in this world since 1.8. Like I quickly checked it out in 1.9 to see if anything broke. And wow, we haven't played since 1.8 here. But I am no longer lost in the nether. I'm clever. I'm clever like that. Although I probably would have been even smarter if I removed all of this slow sound and put something like ice there so I can jump faster. The reason I have ice all the time on me, by the way, is so that it just makes it easier, really. This is a sort of destruction. Okay, that works good. If you one hit kill a zombie pigman, they don't let other pigmen know that you've hit them. Which is really smart. Okay. And I prefer using this sword because it's more original, because the other one was obtained by command blocks. But as I said, let's get the hell out of here. I don't really know what else to show you guys. I really don't. Let me quickly think of something. Oh yeah, I remember now. I need to go in spectator mode for this because I kept getting lost. Game mode 3. You can see all the underground stuff. This is Barsnip Kings. Everyone linked up together in the underground. Thing is that if any of you DoomCrafters are watching this, you are not permitted to build within 100 blocks of spawn of the spawn village. You have to go outside 100 blocks. And simply because there's like shops here and things like this, my whatever this is, yeah, mob system. Thing is, I started building this, yeah, and before they started building this, so technically I have rights over this land, but they would not let me carry on building, and the reason I couldn't make this work is because I didn't have the space. So, more underground stuff. Oh yeah, I lit up most of the caves around here for perfect spawn rates. Most of the caves. That took a long, long time. Something you should never do, or attempt by yourself. Got lots of stuff here. Lots and lots of stuff. I'll take those, thank you. Oh, I can't take that. I can't do that. Anyway, I'm going to show you inside the mob system, just in case you wanted to see how it's all done. And don't ask any questions on how to build it. You can just see from here. You might have to turn your brightness up a bit. But this is how you build it. And you just copy each layer. And you can see there's lots and lots of mobs here. Which is good. Very good. Game mode 0 again. Actually, you won't be able to actually build it by just looking at this. I'm going to put the sniper tower over there on top of a hill. The sun is rising, which is good. Whoops. Am I going to die? Oh. That was close. Oh man. I love feather falling. Oh, I know why I was taking so much damage this whole episode. I took all my armor off. Wow. Just wow. I was a zombie pigman in there. Oh. It all makes sense now. Okay. Well, I honestly don't know what else to show you. The spawn thingamajigger is right there. I think I know how to end the episode. Okay. F5 first of all. Oh, why am I not DoomSkull again? Okay. Game mode. I forget, yeah. Shut up, I've just woke up. It's not fair. What I was thinking of is taking like a big screenshot of the whole world. And using that as a thumbnail, one, and two, to watch the sunrise. Last sunrise. I think that's what I'm going to call the episode, Last Sunrise. That'll be pretty cool. I'm not going to go take a screenshot of that area because just who cares? There's nothing there. Okay, I got everything in the shot. Nothing's loading in apparently. Okay. Thank you for watching, guys. And I might want to go into game mode 1. Thank you for watching, guys. This is the last episode of DoomCraft, and I'll see you in the next season. Bye!